I'm starting out with the Tarte Clean Slate Brightening Primer, and I'm just massaging that into my skin. This primer gives you like a beautiful luminous glow, which I love. And then I'm going in with the Marc Jacobs Remarcable Foundation, and I'm just dotting some of that onto my face and then blending it out using my beauty blender. This was my first time trying this foundation and I am obsessed. It is incredibly beautiful and such good coverage. I love it. Then to cream contour, I'm taking my Tarte Pro Glow palette and I'm using the cream contour shade. And I'm just applying it to my face with a Sigma F61 brush. This is an amazing brush to actually apply your cream products. I really love the shape of it for that. But then I'm using an F57 brush to buff this into the skin. And I forgot how much I love this cream contour. Like, you can see how sculpted and amazing it makes my cheeks look. I did just take my beauty blender just to make sure all those edges were blended and then went back in with the F57 brush to finish blending it all out. Moving on to the eyes, I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape to prime my eyelids for the eyeshadows. So I'm just using my beauty blender to blend that out. And then I'm going in with my Benefit Hello Flawless Powder in Ivory. And I'm just taking an F35 tapered highlighter brush and just basically setting all of my eyelids. Then taking some tape, I'm just applying it to the outer corners of my eyes. And going into the Huda Beauty Desert Dusk palette, I'm first taking the shade Eden and I'm buffing this into my crease using an E40 brush from Sigma. This isn't a super pigmented shade, but I like that. You can kind of build it up. Then I'm taking this shade, which is, I believe, amber, and I'm just doing the same thing, just focusing this into my crease. Then taking the shade Blazing, which is a super orange shade, I'm pretty much doing the same thing. I just really wanted to build up all of these colors to make it look super blended and seamless. So basically just doing the exact same thing with this shade. Then I'm taking the shade Saffron, which is one of my favorite shades from the whole palette. It's like a gorgeous cranberry reddy kind of color. And I'm taking my E25 brush and I'm kind of packing this on the outer corner and blending as I go. And then taking the shade Oud, I think it's pronounced, and I'm just doing the same thing, just focusing this on that outer corner and building up the intensity. So once I'd sort of built it up in the outer corner, I started to blend in through the crease and drag a bit of product in there. Then I'm just going back in with my E40 brush and making sure all of those colors are blended together. And then I'm going in with the shade Turkish Delight, and I first took a brush, but it just was not working for me. So I ended up taking my finger and it worked a lot better, and I started to pack this onto the inner part of the eyelid. And then taking the shade Royal, which I actually don't really like this shade. It did not show up on my eyes hardly at all. So, I mean, you can see it here, but once I blended it, like, you could barely see it. So, kind of disappointing. But I took my E25 brush and just blended those edges. So, that's when I took a brush and tried to pack on the shade Royal, and it just honestly rubbed off my other eyeshadows. Like, wait until this part, see, you can see on my eyelid, it just pretty much took the entire shade off. So that was pissing me off, so I used my finger to apply more of it and just left it at that. Then I took the shade Desert Sand and I just highlighted my brow bone with that. And then once again, I went in with that Sigma E40 brush and just blended the edges to make sure everything was very seamless. And then I removed the tape and applied some eyeliner in my waterline. This one's just a Models Prefer Kohl pencil in black. So I applied that in my tight line and then just applied a really, really tiny amount into my lash line. Then I used the Marc Jacobs Velvet Noir Mascara, and for the falsies, I use the Ardell Faux Mink in, I think, 811. And then back onto the face, I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape for my concealer. This one's in the shade Light Sand, and I just applied it to all of those usual areas that I always apply my concealer. And as you can see, it's super full coverage, so I had like the most flawless full coverage look going on in this makeup look, but I was feeling it. Then I'm just using the Benefit Hello Flawless powder again to set those areas on my face, and I just used an F25 brush. I also, as you can see, I just took a little bit underneath where I contoured, so to make it stand out a little bit more. Then going back into the Pro Glow palette, I'm taking the powder contour shade and I'm using an F23 angled brush to apply this to my cheekbones, really carve them out, and then apply some around my hairline and my temples, underneath my jawline and under my bottom lip, just all of the usual areas. For blush, I used Milani Baked Blush in Luminoso, which is an oldie but a goodie. And then for highlight, I took the top left shade. I have no idea what it's called, but I'll link it down below. And I just used an F42 fan brush to apply this to the tops of my cheekbones, my cupid's bow, my chin, down my nose, and above my brows for a nice glowy look. And then I went in with my Algenist Splash Setting Spray to set my base in place. Moving back onto the eyes, I took Eden again and just started to buff this underneath the lower lash line, and I was using an E25. Then I took the shade Amber and pretty much did the same thing. I just wanted to work up the colors and make it super smoky. Then I took Oud and I used a E30 pencil brush and really smudged this into the lower lash line. And then going into Saffron, I just added a little bit of that to make it a bit more like red and smoky. And then taking Twilight, which is this beautiful purpley iridescent shade, it's amazing. And I just applied that to the lower lash line on the inner sort of portion, and then used MAC Vanilla Pigment to highlight my inner corners. Then I just took that black liner from earlier and lined my waterline and finished off the eyes with a little bit of lower lash mascara. For the lips, I first lined them with this Maybelline Nude Whisper lip liner, which is one of my favorite lip liners ever. So I just completely outlined them and then filled them in with the Tarte lip paint in the shade Namaste, which I love, love this nude so much. And that completed the entire look. I really hope you guys enjoyed it, and I will see you in my next one. Bye.